shut up before I smack you over the head with it. Celebration weekend.
Celebration weekend. So, one of us is retired.
Who could that be? I have no idea.
Can you guess which one of us has retired?
Bit longer for me, another month to 6 weeks, and then I'll be doing that happy dance too.
Yeah. So I've got a new bike coming, so I'm going to spend, in my head, the month riding my bike and getting fit.
Not in my head.
In your head, I'm doing what?
Decking, fences, gates.
Yeah, that's...
Yeah, you will do, because you're good like that.
No. So anyway, yeah, so... Second retirement, still to come.
Yeah.
And after that, I think our plans are around the 6th of
November. Roughly, yeah, because we were originally going to set off a bit earlier, but then we'd have had to come back in January, wouldn't we? So we're making it November, so we can stay till, hopefully, sort of like end of Feb.
So our plan so far looks a bit like this. We get on the ferry, we arrive in Holland, we go through Belgium, we arrive at a place called Rockroy, which we've been to before. And we went to it on the way home last year, but yeah, we never got to see anything because everything was shut. France is usually shut
at Christmas. Yeah.
France is shut a lot of the time. It's really weird.
Yeah.
Especially when you're off the beaten track. So we're going to go there and see what that was actually like in daylight. And then after that, we have no plans between what will be the 7th of November.
And about the 22nd.
22nd of December.
I think we're going to Benidorm on the 22nd of December, I think.
So it's about a month and a half, maybe a bit more.
Our way around.
We have no idea. So if anybody has been through Spain and can recommend some places, whether it's Frieres, beaches, stuff, hit us up with some comments because...
Definitely,
we have no plans.
Yeah, and all advice gratefully received.
Yeah.
We've got a list anyway, haven't we? Things we've picked up off other
people. We've been watching videos left, right and centre and just putting them on a map. And the map now looks like we could spend a year going around them. But if anybody's got any recommendations of where to go, be brilliant. We will have to drop into campsites as well. So any decent price campsites, because we'll want to do our water and do all our toilet and stuff. So that would be good as well. But all around...
In between that, we're just going to do airs, aren't we?
Yeah. And we're going to do a lot of biking, hopefully.
Hopefully. Get fit.
Yeah.
That's the aim of the game, isn't it? Get fit.
Yeah. And then after Benidorm, there's a chance we might now go to Portugal for a little bit to see some mates. We were going to go straight to Morocco, but we might go to Portugal, come back, go to Morocco, then come home and make a dash back to England.
Yeah.
And then don't know what we'll do when we get back.
Well, I'll probably pick a bit of work up.
And then go travelling again.
Yeah.
So we'll see. So, yeah. If you've got any idea where we should be heading in Spain, recommendations, heading in Portugal, anywhere in between France and Spain, any recommendations there?
We're just going to wing it.
Yeah. So we'll just put them on the big list of things, of options. So, yeah.
Oh, and I want to do quite a bit of swimming, don't I? So I would really, really like to know if anyone knows where there's any thermal springs or anything like that, because I plan to swim round as many sort of pools and lakes and bits and pieces en route as well, don't I?
Yeah, but if you don't know any springs, don't worry about it because it means I don't have to go swimming with her. So that's good as well.
Yeah.
Right, so cheers.
Cheers.
Got our little cheap version of the posh ovens on the go. So we're camped up, aren't we?
Yes.
So yeah.
That's
all lit. It's been a while, so I'm burning it off.
Yeah.
To actually heat it all up a bit, but yeah. For cheaper things, they work just as good and you save yourself a couple hundred quid. So we're going to have pizzas tonight. Although there is a big posh pizza oven going on the other side of the campsite in there.
There's a what?
Posh pizza oven going on the other side.
Yeah, but we like our pizza oven.
So I've made the dough already.
Yeah, very organised.
The trick's the Nduja sausage. That's what makes the pizzas taste really nice, isn't it?
I'm looking forward to it.
So
I'm hungry.
Need to get the kit out because that's starting to burn up and we'll make some pizzas and get some beer on the go. Yeah?
Definitely.
Right, come on then.
So here we have man at work, making himself useful, creating our pizzas. So a bit of chilli chopping and onions are already done there. We've got some pepperoni. We've got some Nduja sausage. We've got some fresh mozzarella there that he's chopped as well. So basically that's all the
all the prep for the toppings, and then he's going to roll out the pizza dough shortly. Yeah. And make me a delicious pizza for tea.
Yeah.
So he made this pizza dough at home and rolling it out of that special little mini van roller.
Sort of like individual sized pizzas, but they're blooming lovely and they cook absolutely brilliantly in that pizza oven. Proper little mini stone baked pizzas.
How's your first pizza?
Yum.
And the second one's on the go.
Mm-hmm.
Third. Are you dead proud of the little pizza you made?
Ta-da! Yeah, and I can do pizza too.
Although I'm doing the pizzas, Nikki's not impressed with the, what do you call it?
Table of chaos.
Okay. It's a workstation.
Oh. Our little pizza oven, as you've seen, it's carnage when I get involved. Nikki can't handle that because she's a right tidy freak. But it keeps me busy. So I'm too busy stoking the fire because it runs off pellets, making the pizzas, putting the pizzas in, watching the pizzas, getting the pizzas out, making the next one, putting more stuff in, keeping it all going. So I can't drink as much, which we found when we used it in Scotland. Kept me off the beer when we're at the campsites, too busy making pizzas. So it's great, but we're not going to take it with us now that we're retiring and going to south of Spain, because at the end of the day, it's a big thing. It takes up quite a bit of space in the back for something you don't use that often. Especially if you go into a country that has lots of French food and Spanish food, why are you going to go make a pizza? Doesn't make sense. So we're going to leave that here. We're not going to take it with us. Although, I do know that a load of Geordies were dead happy when Sambuca's from Newcastle opened one in Benidorm because they didn't like that Spanish muck. So they could go there and eat a Geordie pizza. Geordie's for you. I am from Newcastle, by the way, before anybody gets upset. So we think that if we do want to make a pizza, we can make it in a Ridge Monkey. So we're going to try that tomorrow and see if we can actually make one in a Ridge Monkey just for a test.
So we had a little bit of pizza dough left from Friday night and we're going to test whether we can cook a pizza or flatbreads or anything like that in the Ridge Monkey. So Billy's just rolled it out. He rolled the dough out first, popped the dough in. I've topped it, so it's got like salami, nucha, mozzarella, etc. And we're gonna pop it on the gas now and see if it cooks. Pizza in, on the Ridge Monkey. And we'll see how that goes. So fingers crossed, eh? We're pretty sure this is cooked. The only thing that might be a bit doughy is these thick corners. But we're pretty sure that's an okay pizza. So we're going to do the taste test.
So taste test.
So the verdict is pizza for breakfast. Mmm.
Crispy base.
Really crispy. This is the bit I thought wouldn't be cooked, but I think it's absolutely fine.
Excellent. So we don't need to take the pizza oven with us anyway, because we can make little pizzas in our Ridge Monkey. And it's a lot less mess than trying to make a big pizza outside.
Red hot. Really nice. So another thing I find really, really useful in the van is these silicon fruit or veg containers. I think I paid £6.99 and I got a pack of four off Amazon, sort of all different shapes and sizes. So basically, they're flat. Just take that onion out. They just store flat like that, so they don't take up any room. Obviously, they're environmentally friendly because you're not using cling film or anything like that. And they completely keep smells out. Well, every time you open your fridge door, you don't smell onion because it's sealed perfectly in here. And also, it keeps them fresh because the silicon molds to the shape of whatever you put in there. So this is a stinky red onion. Just pop it on, screw it in, seals it. Keeps it perfectly fresh, stops, don't need to use cling film, and stops all those stinks. I love them.
So as you can see, the weather is crap. So that's why we're holed up, isn't it?
We are holed up. With that holed up, we're debating whether to even go use the campsite showers or whether to actually use our own shower.
So there'll be lots of YouTubers who talk about what to do on a horrible day, and they sit and they have games and they do this and that. What have we done?
Went to the pub.
Yeah, went to the pub for hours.
We did do a walk first, because that is our rule.
Right, out for a walk in August, wrapped up, look.
Yeah,
delay.
Blowing a hoolie.
Blowing a hoolie. So, yeah, can you wait to go somewhere warm this for winter? It'll be warmer this winter than it's been warmer in Spain for winter than it's been here in bloody summer.
I do love it here, I don't mind, because I always get late.
Yeah. Whatever happened to summer? Apparently it's nice next week.
Yeah.
Which is quite good for people who are retired.
Not me. We do have a rule, and it's got to be a minimum of like a 3 mile walking, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Minimum of like 5K.
So an hour's walking, 4 hours in a pub.
Yeah. But you know, we do have a rule about exercise, and to be fair, you only went to the pub to get more steps in.
Yeah, so don't listen to people who say you can play Monopoly, play cards. Go to the pub. It's much more fun.
You could play Monopoly, you could play cards.
Don't be miserable. Go to the pub.
But to be fair, it is Bank Holiday weekend. That is probably the only reason we went to the pub on a Sunday afternoon.
No, it's not. I go to the pub on a Sunday afternoon. Every day's a Sunday for me now. I'm retired.
We can jack that in.
Don't wanna sleep in, cause I got something to prove. I gotta take what I hate and find a...
They've split it now, look. Have you seen, they've got half an inch. She's got the bit back in her mouth.
What are you saying?
I said I'm covered in mud.
Well, managed to get round most of the ride, not bad.
I know.
So, finished the ride, and in true style, we're off to the pub. Having just been to a pub, but we're off to another one. Right, it's getting rocky. Oh, I better put this phone back and get both hands on the bars.
Sharon has decorated our van while we've been out riding.
So we couldn't show you that before because you'd have guessed without the faces who's retired. It's me.
What's for tea tonight then?
We are having chorizo pasta.
One of our go-tos, isn't it?
Yeah, with pesto and red onions, chilies. And we're going to have some garlic bread.
So how sharp is that knife that we
really
told people to buy?
Really, 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 really sharp.
Somebody's cut themselves on our new sharp knife.
I literally just caught it. Literally just caught my finger.
Better check this, Sheree.
Yeah, you best check it's all right, aren't you? Yeah. But I'll tell you what, it's a cracking knife and I won't be getting my fingers in the way again. Excuse my helmet hair.
No.
Oh, we've just got back as well, and what a lovely surprise. Sharon's decorated the front of the van in Billy's smug, retired face. It looks great. Doesn't it? What a treat.
It was a treat.
Yeah, it's really nice, and I must keep an eye on this because...
Yeah, watch your fingers.
So, I'm going to cook the chilies, the chorizo, and the onions, and the ridge monkey, and then just do the pasta in the pan.
And what about the garlic bread?
I was going to do it in the ridge monkey, but I'd have to clean it all, wouldn't I? Mess about. So I might just stick it under the grill.
Okay, okay. Right, so there you go. Tonight's tea.
Turn that down a bit.
You love this ridge monkey, don't you?
I do love this ridge monkey.
There you go. You're enjoying it.
Ready for it.
Right, we'll get this down and we'll have our showers, eh?
Enjoying this bit of sunshine as well.
So, it's the simple things that please Nikki. Here's Nikki to explain you about something that makes her really excited and she loves. What is it, Nikki?
Well, obviously I'm going to wash up, but I find it so much easier with a bucket than a bowl. So, I was always losing things before, but I do prefer carrying this over to the pot wash.
Off you go, with your marigolds on. Enjoy.
When I leave this life, I put myself into a soul inside. Why does she need a warning sign? Running around my mind. Walk 500 more. In the field and I'm here for 5,000 miles to lay down at your door. Charlemagne, Charlemagne.
Yum.
enjoyed yourself.
Now the next one's number 40. That's Harry Anderson Beck with his four-mile Farmall McCormick Cup. Little beauty now. Look at that
now. I wasn't bigger than that.
And next we have the Massey Group.
Another fantastic weekend in the Van Dunn. That's us a week closer to both being retired and a week closer to setting sail and heading to southern Spain and Morocco on our winter adventure. If you've liked anything in the video, give us a big thumbs up. And if you'd like to come on the journey with us, just hit subscribe. It's completely free. And remember, if you've got any experiences of Spain, Portugal or Morocco and you think you can help, put your suggestions in the comments. We really appreciate them. So thanks for watching, and we'll leave you with some more of Reith's show.